You don't believe in anything, do you?
Of course I do.
Really?
What? Well, anything that's real to me. Things that I can see or hear, touch, smell, taste, and swallow.
And the things you don't understand,
dismiss them.
It must make everything very easy, doesn't it?
Comfortable is the word.
I envy you, Jeff.
Why?
You seem to be very satisfied.
I am, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Well, that's the silliest thing I've ever heard. You've got a fine job, you're engaged to a fine girl, and right now you're lost in a fine forest. What more could you want?
I don't know, but something seems wrong. Especially about Jane and me. That makes everything seem wrong.
I don't know what could be wrong about it. She's young, attractive, and fits smack into your niche in life. And on top of that, she loves you. Just the proper amount, too.
What's the proper amount?
Well, enough to make you happy, but not enough to embarrass your friends.
This looks ideal, doesn't it? Why don't I see it? I mean, I put off my wedding, and... Well, it...
Come on. You can't talk yourself into an inferiority. You don't deserve it.
What do you mean?
Well, all my friends who do have inferiority complexes are absolutely right. They're not as good as everyone else. And someone like you, who's got the looks and great job, I mean, they're...
Do you hear that?
Two.
Look over there.
That looks like a village.
It is.
I thought you said there weren't any villages around here.
I did. Look, it's right there. There's a peculiar heavy fog all around it. There's no mist anywhere else in the valley. Only around the village. Getting too far from here. Let's go check it out.
Wait till Rand McNally hears about this.
Come, 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 come Me and your life. and getting married is the only way you can do it that's proper.
Sure.
What?
Sell me something and it will.
I'm sorry, sir, but I cannot sell you anything. However, if you're thirsty, I'll give you some milk.
No, thanks. I don't want any favors.
I see from the corn you're from England.
No, actually, we're Americans.
I'll go home with Bonnie Jean.
Go home, go.
darling. I'll be over. I hope, sir, you'll stay for the wedding supper.
I don't know if I'll be here that long.
Oh, tis a pity.
Charlie, what are we going to do all afternoon?
Rest, dearie. Rest.
He's a nice kid.
Aye, he is that.
It's so refreshing to see a fellow so enthusiastic about getting married.
It is so unusual.
Well, it is me. I'm not bubbling over like Charlie, and next month I'm facing the minister.
You're getting married?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, what?
I'm very surprised. Somehow you didn't seem like the sort of lad who would want to settle down.
I didn't say that. I just said I was getting married.
If you feel that way about it, why are you?
Because the girl wants to.
Is that reason enough?
I don't know how it is in the Highlands, but in my neighborhood, if you've been going with a girl long enough and she decides she wants to get married, you better agree right away and save yourself a whole lot of trouble.
Why?
Because if you don't try to torment you until you marry her for relief, she'll be so sweet to you about it, you can't help but feel guilty. Your conscience will make you do it.
I must say, it didn't sound like you love her very much.
It doesn't, does it?
And it also sounds like a very peculiar line to come from.
Well, believe me, lass, this isn't your usual Hamlet off the highway, either. What was that business that Charlie was talking about? Someone with a miracle?
Oh, that. I'm sorry, I can't say.
But you said you'd tell me later.
I know, but I can't say.
That's fine. You know, if I stick around this place long enough, I'll probably find everyone here is slightly nutty. Is that possible?
I can't say.
Why not?
Because I didn't know what nutty means.
Oh, it means slightly insane.
Well then, I can assure you, we're not far from insane. We're the most blessed group of people. And I never realized how fortunate we are until I meet someone from the outside. I mean, a stranger to my youth. I didn't know anything about you, but from the little you've told me, everything you think, I think differently about. And I'm also quite certain that what I think is much more, well, pleasant. And I'm sorry I've said all that, but you angered me when you called us insane.
You don't like me very much, do you?
What's the odd part? I like you very much. I just didn't like anything you say.
Fiona.
Aye.
If I stuck around here today, would you take me to the wedding this evening?
Why do you suddenly want to go?
I cannot say.
Well then, I'll take you. And I'll be highly pleased you'll be there.
You will? Why?
Because of what I just told you. I like you very much.
That's right, you did say that, didn't you?
Now I'll take you someplace where you can lie down and rest.
Where are you going?
To gather some heather for the wedding.
But where do you do that?
On the hill, where the heather is.
May I come with you?
No, I'll do it much faster alone.
No, I won't bother you, really. Maybe I'm the one who's a little nutty. But...
can't we two go walking together around? Out where there's a hillside of heather, curtsying gently in the breeze. That's what I'd like to do. See the heather with you. The mist of May is in the glen, and all the clouds are holding still. So take my hand and we'll go roaming.
Falling in love and just being sentimental because you're tired.
that what I was being? Sentimental because I'm tired?
I believe so. But 'tis very agreeable. The mist of May is in the gloaming, and all the clouds are old as you. So take my hand and move along me through the heather on the hill. The morning dew is blinking yonder, there's lazy music in the rill, and it is a lovely time to wander through the heather on the hill. There may be other days as rich and rare, there may be other springs as full and fair, but they won't be the same, there will be good
for this, I know.
One day she was walking. That's what I'm referring to. I thought you were interested in me, and that's why you let me take you here. You misled me.
You certainly have one hell of an imagination. Can you think of one good reason why I, a strange man, would be interested in you, a strange woman, and at this hour of the day?
Of course I can, because you're a lad and I'm a lass.
That philosophy, you must have had a very provocative career.
Thank you.
an enemy.
You may not mean to be, but you are. And so is everyone else in this town.
What is it, lad? Why do you go about hating everybody?
I couldn't have made through this day of seeing a medic someone else if I didn't. What can I do? What can anyone do but hate when you realize that your life didn't mean a damn? I cannot leave here. I cannot go to university and make something of myself. Not can I help you. So there is nothing left to do but hate everyone and everything in this cursed town.
You'll never find any peace by hating, lad. You'll only shut yourself off more from the world. Besides, this is only a cursed town if you make it so. For the rest of us, this is a blessed place.
But you can keep it.
Oh, all done. Sorry about that.
Tina Fashla.
Oh, Jeannie.
Charlie, please go away.
Dunno, Berla. You'll spoil her.
I can hardly wait for the wedding.
Jeannie.
Because they've told me I can't behold you till when music starts playing. To ease my longing, there's nothing wrong in me.
Thank you.
they've told me I can't behold you till when music starts playing. To ease my longing, there's nothing wrong. So I've been out here and saying,
I could swear I was falling.
19. What's the matter? People used to get married then. Oh, wait a minute. Children. Fiona, born October 10, 1722. Jean, born April 8, 1728. Well, but Fiona's 24, and she has a sister 6 years younger named Jean. Well, those are the two sisters in this Bible.
It's ridiculous. They're probably just named after them.
Did you know that Jean's getting married today?
I did.
Do you know the name of the guy she's marrying?
Someone at the tavern told me. Someone, Dalrymple.
Dalrymple. Now get this. Married. Jean McLaren to Charles McPherson Dalrymple. May 24, 1746. Now what do you say to that?
Congratulations.
Wait a minute. No Brigadoon on the map. No phones in the whole town. Thanks to Mr. Somebody or Other for postponing a miracle. A few of the things I passed over when I was out with Fiona today.
You're right, and that hyperthyroid I was with never heard of Jack Daniels.
I don't understand it. Beginning to feel like a damn fool.
Well, I guess if it makes him happy to disregard 200 years of human bing bang, let him.
I just spent the most wonderful day of my life, and suddenly I come across something like this. It just doesn't make sense to me.
Well, it makes sense to me. It just means that batty people relax you.
She's not batty. She can't be. Fiona! There must be a logical explanation for this. Even logical enough for you. Fiona!
They don't need to explain anything to me. I don't care.
Come here.
Tommy, what is it?
Is this your name in the Bible here?
I? And what? Oh.
Somebody seems to have loused up your books.
Well, come on. Is there an explanation or isn't there?
Aye, there is. But I can't tell you.
Well, who can? I'd like to know.
You have to speak to the Dominie.
The who?
Our schoolmaster, Mrs. Lundy.
Where does she live?
Up the road in a tree.
She doesn't live in a tree, Mr. Douglas. Mrs. Lundy's a great one. All right, Tommy, I'll take you to her. I hadn't wanted to, because I was hoping we could have this day together.
What does that have to do with anything?
It is going to be so hard for you to believe what you'll hear. You'll think there's something wrong with us, and then you'll leave. I just know it.
Well, maybe I will. Maybe I won't. Come on, Jeff, let's go.
Is it informal, or is that on my three-horn hat?
Come on, I said!
I'd love to hear it all again.
Of course.
folk away from the teachings of God and putting the devil in their souls. They were indeed highly destructive women. I didn't suppose you have such women in your world.
Witches? We still have them. We just pronounce it a little differently.
It didn't matter. They were not real sorcerers. Because he and I know there was no such thing, but their influence was very real indeed. Now, here in Brigadoon, we had an old minister of the Kirk named Mr. Forsyth. And a good man he was.
The kindest man in Scotland.
I believe he was. No man ever loved his parish as did Mr. Forsyth. But he was growing old, and it grieved him to think that someday soon he'd leave all those so dear to him. But what he worried about most of all, it was the witches. They hadn't visited Brigadoon yet, but he knew there was a band of them coming our way. So he started wondering if there wasn't something he could do to protect the folk of his parish. Not only from them, but from all the dangers that could come from the outside world after he died.
Such a kind man.
So, for many days, he walked through the glen thinking, and if you passed his house any hour of the night, you would see the candles lit, and Mr. Forsyth sitting in his chair thinking. Then one day, he came to me, and he told me he was going to ask God for a miracle.
His heart is so nice that you try thinking about it.
He consulted with me because he knew I have a highly logical mind, and if he was going to ask God for a miracle, might as well be a well-organized miracle. So, for many days, I walked through the glen with him, and for many nights, I sat with him by candlelight. Then finally, Mr. Forsyth decided what he was going to pray for. So on an early Wednesday morn, right after midnight, he went out to a hill beyond Brigadoon and made his prayer to God. There, in the hush of a sleeping world, he asked God to make Brigadoon vanish into the highland mist. Vanish, but not for always. It would all return just as it were once every 100 years. The people would go on leading their customary lives, just each morning when they awoke, it would be 100 years later. And that next morning when we awoke, it was 100 years later.
My God.
You see, in this way, Mr. Forsyth knew there would be no change in the lives of the people. They just wouldn't have been any century long enough to be touched by it.
So, what you're saying is, when you go to bed at night and you wake up the next morning, it's 100 years later?
Aye.
So each day is 100 years later.
Aye.
Well, what happened to this minister?
We never saw him again. You see, Mr. Forsyth knew to ask for such a miracle, a sacrifice would have to be made. And he wanted to be the one to make it. Now, what could be the greatest sacrifice he could offer? It was to be separated before his time from the ones he loved. So that's why he went out to a hill beyond Brigadoon. Were the miracle granted, he would never see Brigadoon again.
And all this happened 200 years ago?
Aye, lad, which is only 2 days ago to us. Mr. Forsyth intended to ask for the miracle on Tuesday, but Charles Dalrymple was in school in Edinburgh, and he wasn't expected back till Tuesday late. Not wanting anything to go wrong with the wedding, Mr. Forsyth postponed praying until Charlie got back.
Wasn't that sweet of him?
So, suppose someone here gets fed up and wants to leave, could they?
Oh no, he cannot leave.
Wait, do I have to stay here?
No, lad. But if anyone of Brigadoon leaves, the enchantment is broken for all.
And
that night when the people go to sleep, Brigadoon will disappear forever.
Look, I'm not saying I believe all this, but suppose someone came to Brigadoon, someone like me, came and wanted to stay, could he?
Why, lad, he could. Mr. Forsyth provided for that.
He didn't miss a trick, not at all.
Glad you did. A stranger can stay if you love someone here. Not just Brigadoon, mind ye, but someone in Brigadoon enough to want to leave everything behind and stay with that one person. Which is how it should be. Because after all, lad, if you love someone deeply, anything is possible.
I think I like that part best.
Shouldn't you be thinking about helping Jeannie with the wedding?
I had. Oh, Tommy, will I see you later?
Yes, I'll be here.
Thank you, Tommy. I must be going. Thank you, Mrs. Lundy.
She's a dear lass.
I'm finding that out. Tell me, Mrs. Lundy, you're all perfectly happy living in this town?
Of course, lad. After all, sunshine can peep through a small hole.
But when you go to bed at night, what is it like?
Well, for me, it's just like being carried on shadowy arms to some far-off cloud, and there I sleep till morning. And yet sometimes I think I hear strange voices.
Voices?
Aye. They say no words I can remember, but their voices fill with a fearful longing. 'Tis the wedding time.
If you both promise to be good and true to each other, then you cannot help but
I'm leaving, Brigadoon. It is the end of all of us. The miracle's over!
All that we wished was to keep him from leaving. Alone with the tide was he. I looked and Vicar McDougall,
Jeff, I'm not going back with you.
Hold on a minute. Just for the record, what are you talking about?
I'm not going back with you. I'm staying here.
You're pulling my Bonnie leg.
No, I'm not. Never been more serious about anything in my entire life. I tell you, in just one day, I feel more a part of her in this place than I ever have about Jane or anything back home.
Well, that's because it's just one day. But what you don't realize yet is if you stay here, it's for always.
I know.
And do you realize how long always is around here? It's one hell of a long time.
I know.
And this can't be a trial and error, because you can't change your mind after trying it out for 600 or 700 years.
But I won't ever want to.
You're absolutely sure that there will never come a time where you could miss your family or your friends or anything from the old life you're leaving behind? How can you know that now?
Because, and here's where you're going to think I'm crazy. It's because I believe in her. And what's more, I believe in this place.
You do not. You just think you do. This Highland voodoo town makes no more sense to you than it does to me. So, how can you believe in something when you don't understand it? When you leave here in a few weeks or even days, you'll forget all about it and you won't feel a thing. Because that's the way a dream is.
What do you mean, a dream?
Well, that's what this is. It's a dream. Like, right now, you're not really moved by it. You just think you are.
Well, how can you know?
Because I do. Did you see that funeral here a few moments ago?
Yes.
Well, I'm responsible for it.
What?
Harry Beaton? I killed him.
You did what?
I killed him, okay? Accidentally, of course, I swear. Earlier tonight, I was out in the forest, minding my own business, and then from behind a bush, and it came rushing past. I stuck out my foot, and down he went. I heard his head hit the rock. Oh, this is a nasty thud.
Oh my God, Jeff, I'm so sorry.
What for?
Well, you must feel half dead inside.
On the contrary, I don't feel a thing.
You mean you actually don't feel anything?
Nothing, except like going home.
Well, why don't you?
Because that's what this is. It's a dream. It's a good one for you, and a bad one.
Wait a minute, will you?
See, now I'm confused, you haven't I?
Yes, you have.
If you really believed in this place just as much as you think you do, I couldn't do that. I'll wait for you outside of town.
What did he mean by that, Tommy? You ought to tell me you want to stay, lad. Tommy, what is it?
It's no good, Fiona. I'm leaving. And it's not that I don't love you. I think I do. I guess I just don't trust my own feelings enough to stay.
You mean you're not sure you can accept everything?
That's about it, I guess.
You better hurry, Fiona. There's not much time left. You shouldn't feel too ashamed of yourself, Tommy. It's the hardest thing in the world to give everything, even though it is usually the only way to get everything.
Do you understand it all?
Thank you. not being in love in vain, but not being in love at all.
But it'll fade in time.
No, it wouldn't do that.
Thousands of miles away, there, with her.
slowly I drift back to the conversation. They ask me a question, and I have no idea what they're talking about. Haven't heard a word.
You, my friend, must be fascinating company.
It's easier when I'm alone.
Tommy!
Jane!
What a wonderful surprise!
Hello, Jane!
When did you get back?
Hello, Jeff!
Just a little while ago. How are you, Jane?
I've been worried up to death about you.
Oh, you know, I'm fine. Well, you know, I've got a little cold, but other than that...
I must say, you do look wonderful.
So are you, Jane.
All right, well, I don't want to eat and run, but I think I'll head up to my room and have a drink.
I'll see you later, Jeff.
Hello.
Goodbye.
Oh, put on the bill, Frank.
Your bill, sir, is, awfully high.
So am I.
Tommy, why didn't you write me?
Nothing to say, I guess. A drink?
Old fashioned, please. And why didn't you wire me you were coming in? After all, darling, I didn't think the minute you get into town, you'd call me, or come to me, or in fact, why didn't
you...
Right. It never faded.
It's unbelievable. Awful and unbelievable.
What is so awful and unbelievable?
I think that somewhere out there, between the mists and the stars, there's someone I want so terribly. She's not dead, only asleep. And yet I'll never see her again.
Did you really come all the way out here just to say that? You could have told me that over the phone. In New York. For a nickel.
I know, but she became so real to me that I had to come here and prove to myself that it all wasn't really here.
See, it didn't work that way for me. You'd have to work hard to convince me that anything had happened at all.
There's a big difference between you and I.
Tell me about it.
I find that sometimes what you believe in can become more real to you than anything you could ever explain away or understand. God, why do people have to lose things just to find out what they mean?
Well, take a last look and let's start walking. I got lost around here once.
Okay.
Bye.